Welcome to the Word of Faith, coming to you from PBC Northgate. We hear God's Word, meditation and prayer. The passage is Romans chapter 8, verse 9. You, however, are not in the realm of the flesh, but you are in the realm of the Spirit. If indeed the Spirit of God lives in you, and if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, they do not belong to Christ. But if Christ is in you, then even though your body is subject to death because of sin, the Spirit gives life because of righteousness. And if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of his Spirit who lives in you. Therefore, brothers and sisters, we have an obligation, but it is not to the flesh to live according to it. If you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if you live according to the Spirit, you put to death the misdeeds of the body, and you will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. Another powerful passage speaking about life and death, speaking about flesh and spirit. Jesus said in John 14, John 17, it is good I go, because if I go, I send you Paraclete, I send you one alongside you, I send you a guide, I send you one who will help you in this journey and remind you of the things that I've taught you. This is the Spirit. Now here he says, if the Spirit of Christ lives in you, then you belong to Christ. And I like how he has placed it. He says, you have now an obligation not to the sinful things, an obligation to the spiritual things. You are either a man of the Spirit or a man of the flesh. You can't do in between. So it's a question that you need to contemplate and decide, are you a man of the Spirit of Christ or are you just a human man? Because a human man is subject to human problems. But a spirit man has power to overcome as Christ overcame. Listen to this scripture. If the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies. Yes. God knows that our bodies are weak and subject to sin, but he has given us a catalyst, an ability, a lifting up. Sin has a level. Now he's taken us beyond. So he says you cannot come down to participate in childish things when you've grown up. He said in 1 Corinthians 13, I was a child, behaved like a child. Now I've grown, I've left childish ways behind me. You cannot participate in both. That's why he says it's an obligation. It means heaven has an expectation on you. They've invested in you, deposited in you the Holy Spirit, because there are works that are expected of you to do. Now, if you are not aware of this, if you don't live up to that standard, then you are going to find that you have slipped down to a human level. And at human level, then you are doing human things. So I just want to remind us today from this passage, Jesus died, buried, and resurrected. That power of resurrection is available to you now so that your mortal body can live in a resurrected state as far as the things of God are concerned. You should be able to see your God. You should be able to commune with your God. Jesus said to the Samaritan woman, John 4:24, a time is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship him in truth and in the Spirit. You have to see this God in the Spirit, because the power that raised Christ from the dead is resident in your life to overcome sin. You have an obligation, and I pray that you'll be faithful to this obligation to live life according to the Spirit of God, not according to the human flesh. May God bless you as you engage the world and as you live in a way that honors God and that helps the Holy Spirit in you to participate in your life, to bear him much fruit. Because this prayer we make in Jesus' name. Thank you.